السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I'm sure Brother Muhammad read this ayah on purpose. The ayah of Hajj. Yeah, the first verse is just Surah Al-Baqarah before the ayah 200. So you go back two ayahs, 198, 199. It's about the Hajj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says Al-Hajj Ashhurun Ma'lumat. Hajj are known in a specific time, in a specific place. Yeah? So there is the month of Hajj, Al-Qa'da, and Al-Hijjah. Yeah? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجَّ. Whoever intend and plan to go for Hajj, what should he do? Wallahi, it's amazing the answer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you're going for Hajj, in Hajj time, you become Hajji, here is what you should be doing. Not learning Tawaf, learning Jamarat, learning Sa'i, learning nothing about the Hajj itself. Allah says, فَلَا رَفَثَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ. You become in i'tikaf. You know, you become not i'tikaf only. You know the i'tikaf when you're inside the masjid? You live like as if you're inside the masjid. No, some scholars say it's like you are waqf. You become property of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we are. You can't cut your nail, cut your hair, put perfume, put... you become waqf, you become slave, truly slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, فَلَا رَفَثَ. No talking of desires and dunya and marriage and even witnessing marriage. It's not allowed. وَلَا جِدَالَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ. Fusuq is open mistakes and sins. You know, openly, you can, yeah. And Allah says, and the third, to really go up to the level, وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِ. No even arguing. You can't be arguing with people about who's right, who's wrong, and yelling and shouting. No. You're in Hajj, subhanAllah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Arafat, then mentioned Muzdalifah, then mentioned, you know, subhanAllah, all these places that you go and see it, it's mentioned in this ayah. And then it finishes off with the dua. رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. This dua you say between the Hajar al-Aswad and the Rukn al-Yamani. At that wall, between these two corners, that's the dua you say it all the time. Every time you go around the Kaaba, you come to this place and you say, Allah, give us the best of this life and the best of the next and protect us from the hellfire. This was the first rak'ah. Second rak'ah, Fatma is not here to tell us what did he read in the second rak'ah. What did he read in the second rak'ah? Anybody was awake in the second rak'ah for 5 cents? Okay, make them 10 cents. What did he read in the second rak'ah? Oh, we're going up 20 cents. Okay, it cost me too much. Surat? إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ. It's also about Hajj. It's also about Hajj? Yes. The surah says to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the victory comes, when the Muslim become victorious and powerful and take Mecca, and Mecca become Muslim, and the idols are removed, and now everybody is praying safely, doing tawaf safely. This is wal-fath, fathu Mecca. Mecca become Muslim. Now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the most powerful man on the planet. Victorious, so victorious. He have 100,000 coming with him for Hajj the next year or so. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to him? Look at any history, at any culture, at any country, at any civilization. What do you do when they become victorious? We see it on TV. What they've done in Iraq, what they've done in Somalia, what they've done in Libya, what they've done in Algeria, what they've done in Asia. Yeah, what they've done. They destroyed, they killed millions, literally millions. Numbers only Allah knows. The ayah says, when you become victorious, فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُهُ. Forget this dunya, And now it's time to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make dua, to seek istighfar, to seek repentance, to turn to Allah. Wallahi, if this is not an evidence that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best of mankind, the best messenger, what else? In the peak of his power, he says, I've done my job, I'm going to what I enjoy most, to pray now. You know, to turn to Allah and say, Allah, perfection belongs to you. All praise belongs to you. Please forgive us. Please forgive our shortcomings and mistakes. It was about this place when Allah gave the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam victory and Mecca becomes Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave tens of thousands of gifts to the elite, the noblemen of Quraysh, of Mecca. So Abu Sufyan had his whole jubba full of gold. Couldn't even stand up from how heavy it is. He couldn't stand up. So the people of Ansar, the young people of Ansar, you know, he says, this is his family. This is his relatives. He'll forget about us now. He lived with us in Medina all these years. Now he's home. He's not going to come back to Medina. And one of the Ansar himself ran to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sa'd ibn Ubadah, and he says, Messenger of Allah, I heard a rumor that the people, young people of Ansar of Medina, saying, you're not giving them anything. You've given millions to the new Muslim, not even Muslim yet, and you're not giving the Ansar anything. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, call for a meeting with only Ansar. It was there. Call for a meeting with only Ansar. And they had the Ansar inside with only very few of the Muhajirin senior Sahaba. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, close the doors. And then he says, I've heard something. What are you guys saying? I heard that you're saying, I've given my relative, my family. I got home now, back home, all this. And they were embarrassed. They didn't answer. Then he says, you should answer. You have every right to answer. You should have said, you came to us as muhajir, refugee. You came to us alone and fugitive and running away and afraid. You came to us poor and we supported you with men and money and homes and security and we gave you. And they were really more embarrassed. And he says, aren't you happy that the people will go home with goats and sheep and camels and you go home with the Messenger of Allah? I'm coming back with you. I told you, I will never, you know, leave you. It's only because I'm born in Mecca, I'm not called the Ansar. I wish I was from the Ansar. If the Ansar goes one way and anybody goes the other, I will go with the Ansar. That people outside heard the weeping from inside, not just crying, they were weeping, all the men from the saying, and they were so happy. They all stood up and so happy. They said, Radina. Rasulullah Hazan wa Nasib. We are so content that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is our share of this deal. It was there, subhanallah, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went back with them, of course, lived in Medina, died in Medina, buried in Medina till today, subhanallah. So this is the days of Hajj, that when people go there, they reflect and they think. And alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us always in the masjid in these special days of the Hijjah to earn the reward. The Prophet ﷺ said, go into the masjid for fard, you earn the reward of Hajj. Sitting down to learn about the Quran, you earn the reward of Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the reward of Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invite all of us and our family to Hajj and Umrah many times in our life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our mistakes and shortcomings. We ask Allah to forgive us, forgive our parents. We ask Allah to protect us and protect our family. We ask Allah to protect our children. We ask Allah to raise their rank in the dunya and akhirah. We ask Allah to increase our iman, to increase our knowledge, and make our family reason for our happiness in this life and the next. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد جزاكم الله خير.